Welcome to my backyard. Today we're going to be talking about evidence. What evidence is and how we properly cite it when we're quoting from a passage or a text. And there are a few different ways to think about evidence. When you first hear that word, you might think of a legal or a crime TV show, but all evidence really means is that you're proving your answer, backing it up, in our case, from a passage. And there are three main ways to provide evidence. Our first way of providing evidence is to paraphrase. When we paraphrase, we take the exact words that the author said and change them to be in our own words. We are very close to what the author is saying, but we alter it just slightly. The second way that we show evidence is to summarize. When we summarize the text, we are also putting it in our own words. That's how it's similar to paraphrasing. But instead of using exactly what the author said, we take a whole paragraph or page or chapter, and we then put the most important pieces in our own words. Summarizing is usually taking a large portion and only telling a little bit of what the author said. The third way we show evidence is to quote. When we quote what the author says, we not only point out their exact words, but we also give them credit. We do not change anything that the author has said when we are quoting. Quotes must include quotation marks and the author's name if we know it. If we don't know the author's name, we need to cite where it came from. The article, the paragraph, the page, whatever that might be. We'll talk a little bit more in detail how to go about quoting a source in today's lesson. So remember, when you're asked to give evidence of a question or some sort of a text, be sure to either paraphrase, summarize, or quote. Quoting is usually the most effective way to get your point across and highly recognized in all papers and essays that you may write.
Give me a picture.